right,
you
David?
You sound very faint. I think it's the distance from this cloud actually back down to the planet.
Hello? Hello?
Yeah.
Hello? Hello?
Yes?
Can you hear me all right?
Yes, I'll try and use the dish.
All right, okay. God shouldn't need to use dishes.
Well, you know, keeping up with the times.
I think you're one of the most worthy gods of the day that we've had so far. Thank you very much for being on the phone to us from your cloud. And of course, you might briefly want to mention the Buddha of Suburbia.
He's on the next cloud but one.
Oh, right. Now, where did this Buddha of Suburbia title come from? Was that the actual... Did it actually come from the name of Hanif Qureshi's novel?
Yes, Hanif Qureshi had the novel out a year or two ago, and it was extremely popular. Then the BBC picked it up and made it this four-part series. And Hanif and I had met a little earlier, actually, on an interview assignment thing. We got on very well indeed, and Hanif asked me if I'd write the incidental music.
Now, you've done incidental music to films before.
Nothing at this level. I mean, this was really quite concentrated effort, you know, to sort of cover 4 hours of drama, really.
And what does incidental music mean? Does that just mean the warbly stuff that goes on while all the action's happening?
Characters through the scenes, giving the scene an atmosphere, which is the kind of atmosphere the director has in his mind. So I worked quite closely with Roger Michel, the director of the play.
And so do all the tracks get named after bits that happen? So that, you know, like track five is... John leaves the house.
I actually made them sort of track A, B, C, and D. But after I'd finished the play, as they were only sort of 10 and 15 second bits of music, I kind of just went off on my own, and I kind of stretched the whole thing into 4 and 5 minute pieces and rewrote them and put lyrics to them. And that's subsequently the album, Buddha of Suburbia, is more like a sort of a piece that's complementary to the play rather than sort of actually referring to it.
I missed part one. Part two's on tonight. Can you just briefly fill me in with what I've missed?
I think probably what you've missed is one of the best pieces of drama here on television.
Oh, fine then.
It really centres around the coming of age of a young Anglo-Indian boy growing up in South London.
Oh, well, so that's another thing that you'll identify with, because it's set in Bromley, isn't it, particularly?
Very much so. Hanif and I both went to the same school, we found out. We were quite a few years apart from each other, but we certainly knew a lot of the same places.
And are you in it, Dave? Are you going to feature anywhere?
What, in it?
Yes.
No, not at all. No, I'm strictly just doing the music side of it. But what it is, I mean, it really is a really excellent and a very texturally rich play. I mean, it touches on racism, isolation, a sense of place in society, secret agendas, and suburban angst.
The only reason I ask if you're in it is that one of the major characters is supposed to be modelled on a mixture of you and Billy Idol.
That's right, yeah, because Hanif also knew Billy Idol. We'd never met before, but so he based... It's sort of an amalgam of Billy and who he knew, and his impressions of what I probably was like.
All right, so which bits are you and which bits are Billy?
Exactly. The silver suit, I think, was definitely me.
I probably use your legs.
I think there were one of them was.
Before we get into the God of the Day specific questions, I was just going to ask you some more General Bowie stuff. Is there going to be a new album from you, David, soon?
Well, obviously the soundtrack album is out this week, and there's a compilation album coming out, a sort of singles compilation coming out also this week with about 30 singles on. I'm actually working on my next album, which I'll start work on just after Christmas. There's a video collection coming out.
Oh, it's actually quite busy, actually.
Yeah, I guess so. Well, yeah, I'm kind of working out what kind of music I want to make. Then I'm also working with Hanif again, and we're writing something strictly for the stage, which we'd like to stage something around 1995.
Okay.
And
so if anyone wants to book you for anything, I think 1998 is about when you're next available, I would have said.
Yes, well, that just covers the weekend. On Monday, I think I'm going to paint.
Oh, okay. Well, that's a nice little kind of inside look as to what gods do on their time off. Are you going to paint anything in particular? Or?
I'm painting a lot at the moment. I used to paint a lot.
Or painting the walls?
I'm painting about one a week.
What, a wall, or...?
No, just the front of the house.
Oh, just the front of the house,
yeah.
Okay. Just wanted to clear that up. Okay, right, David Bowie, God of the day today. Who would you like on your cloud, David?
It was a heavenly body, wasn't it?
Oh, yes, which heavenly bodies would you like on your cloud, yes?
Right, my wife and I would like on our cloud.
Oh, right, so the wife's there,
yes,
as well.
Right. Let's be quite clear. The entire body of work of Tintoretto, the Italian painter.
A body of work. Okay,
yes.
Well, we'll get
You didn't define what kind of body, so
no,
I
that's
thought,
true.
You know.
All right, well, we'll get Tintoretto up there to talk you through it as
okay.
well.
Okay.
Okay, who would you like to make a saint, David?
Elliot Coombs.
Who he?
He's a bloke that I know in America.
And why should he be a saint?
He's a good bloke.
He's a good bloke, fair enough.
Either that or reinstate Christopher, because an uncle of mine gave me a Saint Christopher many years ago, and now it's got no symbolic value, and I really liked wearing it, but... So, reinstate Christopher.
Okay, well, we'll fax the Pope on that, because I think it's down to him. And
he's got a dish as well, I think.
Oh, right, okay, well, you can send him a message direct then.
Yeah.
Anyone you'd like to send a thunderbolt on, David?
No.
No one at all?
No.
You love everybody?
No, but I don't particularly... I'm not a thunderbolt kind of guy, really.
Okay. Maybe in the past you might have been. But
no, not really.
We just got you on a good day. And finally, the miracle you'd like to perform, David?
More serious, I think. I think that tomorrow morning it would be great if the population of the world would awake and not know the meaning of the word foreigner, and also that skin colour would have as little relevance as the colour of one's eyes.
David Bowie, God of the Day, thank you very much indeed for joining us, David.
My pleasure, Simon.
Brings his